She's not here, Chuck.
Mrs. Moore!
Did I scare you?
No, not at all. Did you tell Ariel that I...
Yes, Chuck. I've told her every time you've called.
She must be pretty busy and all.
Mm-hmm. She and the girls went to Wendy Joe's to study.
Really? Because I was just over there, and Wendy Joe said Ariel and Rusty left hours ago.
Oh.
Vi? Who is it, Vi? Mr. Cranston.
Evening, Reverend.
Isn't it a bit late, Mr. Cranston?
That's why I'm surprised Ariel's not at home.
So am I. Good night, Mr. Cranston, and next time, please remember we have a front door for guests.
Yes, sir.
Where is she?
She told me she was going to Wendy Joe's. Don't bother calling, she's not there.
Did you know this?
No, I did not.
So, how does it feel, Vi, now that she's lying to you?
I'm not saying anything until I hear an explanation from her.
It was frightening enough when she was running around with that Chuck Cranston. Now she's out in the middle of the night with this punk who's campaigning to challenge me and the entire town council. How long can you keep defending her?
I'm not defending her. We're not on opposite sides here, are we? Or are we?
Where are you?
Oh, Rusty and Wendy Joe. I mean, we were...
Don't even bother.
I know you weren't at Wendy Joe's.
I can't believe you guys are checking up on me.
Sweetie, how do we know you're not sick or hurt?
I am concerned for your well-being.
Then how come when I'm at home, you're never interested in what I'm thinking or how I feel? But the second I walk out that door, wham! Suddenly you're the concern of
that shot.
Vi, be quiet! She needs to start speaking for herself.
I don't know what good that would do. You don't listen to me any more than you listen to her.
Shut up!
I've never hit anyone before.
I know.
We're losing her, Vi. She's become willful and obstinate.
Like her father.
Well, I am her spiritual guardian.
You used to be her friend.
I don't know what's happening anymore. I don't know what to do.
Yes, you do.
Does it ever cross your mind that I miss you?